In October 2021, the World Health Organization recommended the use of malaria vaccine for prevention of severe malaria and death among children. Countries were urged to include malaria vaccines in their routine malaria strategy plan. In June 2022, Uganda went ahead to start the process of adapting the intervention of the malaria vaccine in a bid to prevent malaria. Health workers were trained in Ghana. In July this year, 2023, Uganda applied for funding from the Global Alliance for Vaccines and Immunization, and it was approved. Now, Uganda will receive malaria vaccines next year.
We were trained on how to approach it. This training happened in Ghana. Those of us that are concerned were taken for training. We started a coordination committee. We sought for recommendation from the NITAG, and went ahead to start the process of resource mobilization and plan budget development.
Currently, there is limited supply. All the countries interested in receiving malaria vaccines will have to share from a pool of 18 million.
One would think that we're going to receive vaccines for the whole country, but it's not the case. Currently, we have very limited supplies because we only have one manufacturer globally. So for the next 3 to 5 years, all the countries that are interested in using the malaria vaccine have about 18 million doses available.
Based on the guidance, Uganda is going to roll out the malaria vaccine first to districts and regions with high severe malaria and death.
We are going to do a phased rollout, and for phase one, which is happening next year into 2025, we are going to start with 5 regions and 19 districts, and we are targeting about 160 children.
And a total of about 863 doses of the Mosquirix RTSS have been allocated for the vaccination exercise.
To extend further and include more children in 2025, and that will move us to about 219, I think 227 children, and that means that we shall get an extra more vaccine, and that year we may get an extra 1 million doses, 478.
Dr. Nabakosa says they have targeted children between the ages of 6 to 18 months. This is because a child's immunity begins to reduce at 6 months.
But when a child, and remember we're targeting high transmission districts, there the chances are high that because it's high transmission, their mothers would have been exposed to malaria somehow, either before they got pregnant or during pregnancy. So this exposure gives the mother immunity, which she passes on to the baby. And this immunity lasts for about 6 months. And thereafter, the child loses immunity. And actually, literature says that majority of the children start suffering severe forms of malaria after 6 months when they've lost that immunity.
The children will receive 4 doses of the vaccine in intervals. The government is to redesign the child health cards in order to include malaria vaccine.
It's not a one dose, like I said. This vaccine is given monthly. The children will be receiving the 3 primary doses. The first dose or the first jab is going to be given at 6 months of age, and the next will be given at 7 months of age, and then the third will be given at 8 months of age. Those are the 3 primary doses. And then the fourth that prolongs the immunity will be given at 18 months of age.
The vaccine is expected to be free and will be provided in all public health facilities. The vaccines will prevent children from getting severe malaria. This is according to Dr. Nabakosa, as she explains how the vaccine works.
It's at no cost. Gavi and government of Uganda have covered all the funding. So all a person needs is to look for transport and they move to a facility or a static or a community outreach post, and they'll be given the vaccine. The guidance will come from their respective districts and their attached health facility.
To focus on preventing malaria presenting in severe forms. It is only severe malaria which kills. So if a vaccine prevents the progression to severe forms, then we save lives.
Dr. Jimmy Opigo, who is the Assistant Commissioner, Health Services, National Malaria Control Division at the Health Ministry, says this is a breakthrough because Uganda as a country has a plan to reduce malaria death by 75%. However, eliminating malaria will require malaria prevention at the household level.
It will still require us to continue with malaria prevention, vector control, and a lot of tools are now available. The game changer will be practices in the households where people put efforts to prevent bites by mosquitoes. That is the game changer. Action by households.
Malaria is one of the diseases that is causing a lot of death in children under the age of 5 years. Rolling out the vaccine will help the country achieve the sustainable development goals.
So just in 2018, our country also committed to adhere to the high burden, high impact. In the high burden, high impact, we really want to look at those places that have a lot of malaria and make sure that we focus on them with high impact.
Dr. Jane Nabakosa explains what took Uganda so long to get the malaria vaccine.
It wasn't among the first five that they wanted to target, and so maybe they could only work with three, and eventually they had to drop Uganda.
To effectively deliver the vaccines to different health facilities in the priority districts in phase one, the health ministry has provided the required infrastructure.
But the onboarding of the COVID vaccine has helped us streamline a number of those challenges. And as I speak, the challenges we have around cold chain management and movement of supplies from say the health facility to the beneficiary and making it accessible, most of them have been addressed. And I think around supply chain and cold chain management, we just have to cater for the extra numbers that are going to come in with the onboarding of the malaria vaccine.
Uganda will receive more doses of the malaria vaccine in 2025. This will bring the total number of doses to 627,200 doses. These doses will benefit 219,727 children. The Mosquirix RTSS vaccine, which was developed by British pharmaceutical giant GSK, has already been administered to more than 1.7 million children in the three African countries of Ghana, Kenya, and Malawi as part of a pilot program. This report has been compiled by Agnes Chota Lengerire for the news.